So it's that time of year, you might be seeing some browning of your yard with a lot of heat going on, some areas of having a lack of rain, including where we are at right here. You might be seeing some of that browning of the lawn, or you might be seeing some brown spots in the lawn. So today let's talk about why that might be happening and what you might be able to do about it. So first and foremost, everything comes down to your grass type and where you're located. So if you're down in the south, the actual heat that you might be experiencing, your grass can handle it and actually prefers the heat, but it does still need water. Now here up on our cool season lawns, where I'm at here, the summertime is very difficult for cool season grass and it does not like the heat. It would prefer the spring and the fall cooler temperatures, but there's something built into it that helps it actually get through the summer stress. And that would be a fact that cool season grass can actually go dormant or can turn sort of a brownish color to protect itself from all of that heat. Now this can't go on forever, but it can actually withstand quite a bit of heat and lack of moisture for quite a bit of time without really having any long-term damage. Now this goes on for months and months and you have a major drought, then you would have some problems on your hands at that point. But in terms of the way that things are browning around here, for anyone that hasn't been watering their yard, everything's starting to get that kind of crispy feel to it. And that's a natural thing, nothing wrong with that. The grass is just protecting itself from the heat. And once the moisture comes back, once temperatures go back to the ideal temperatures for cool season grass, it will start to recover and thrive again on its own. So I think that's probably a common misconception when you're first learning lawn care. A lot of people start to freak out and think that their lawn is dying, but it's really not dying, it's just protecting itself. The same thing happens in the winter time when temperatures are too cold, the grass goes dormant during that period as well, but then it just waits for its ideal temperatures to come back in the spring and grows again. So what can you do if you're experiencing some of that brown looking lawn and it's looking like things are drying out? Well, of course, obviously, you could water it. A lot of people don't have an irrigation system, and then watering becomes a lot more difficult to move hoses around, get even good coverage on everything. And so at that point, what I used to do when I didn't have an irrigation system was just pick and choose which area of my lawn maybe I wanted to keep maintaining and more green during the summer, and which area I was able to just decide, I'm just gonna let this go dormant and I'm not gonna try to do too much to it. So if you decide to let your lawn go dormant or just let it go brown, it can actually withstand this for quite a while. Now, every probably 2 to 3 weeks, if you're not getting any rain whatsoever, I would consider putting a little bit on the plant, maybe a quarter inch or a little less than that, just to make sure the crowns of your plant don't die. But remember that there's tons of natural areas around roadways or tons of yards even in my neighborhood that have never been watered, and every single spring and every single fall they come back and grow just like they always would. Kentucky bluegrass is really good at this. Perennial ryegrass is not quite as good at that, and tall fescue can also die off somewhat if you don't get any water to it whatsoever. But if you're dealing with Kentucky bluegrass especially, it's very good at protecting itself against the heat because it needs a lot of water in general. And so luckily for us, you can let that go if you can't keep up with the watering, and it will come back. One thing though that I would recommend is if you are going to water a certain section of your lawn, stay consistent with that and try to keep up with it and not let things go in and out of dormancy. So again, if you can't do your whole yard and you want to make a decision on maybe just a portion of it, then make sure you're kind of keeping up with that. A lawn needs about 1 to 1.5 inches of water during the hottest parts of the year. Apply those in the really early morning hours when evaporation is low. That'll be your best bet for getting ahead of all that heat during the day. Now, another thing to pay attention to with watering would be to watch the areas around your sidewalks. The cement or anywhere that you have rocks or some sort of sidewalk driveway area, all that sun is hitting down on the concrete or on rocks and gravel, makes it difficult for that grass to hold on to moisture. So watch those areas, especially on low cut turf like I have. Sometimes I come out midday and check some of those and water some of the areas on the corners just to make sure that things don't die off too much in those areas, because it can quickly get very hot, especially if it's in the 90s. Watch those areas closely to make sure you're keeping ahead of that stuff. So what are some other possible causes for actual brown spots in your yard? Well, you could definitely have some damage happening from dog spots. Now, this is one question that I get all the time about dog damage and what can be done about it. So the actual probably easiest thing I could tell you is train your dog to go off of the yard if possible. A lot of you are looking at your screen right now or TV and saying, yeah, Ryan, that's just super easy. I'm really not saying that it is super easy, but if you can at all possible get them to go off of the yard, you're going to have much more long-term success. Now, our dogs come down onto our yard here, and a lot of times they stay up by the shed, which I don't really care about that area up there because I just know that it's going to get damaged and I don't worry too much about it. But they do come out here onto the main area, then the only other thing that you can really do as far as really successful things that you can do is if they're going out during the morning time, bring a little bucket of water. Wherever they go, just dump that little bucket right on there and it's going to dilute everything and you shouldn't have as much of a problem with damage. So you just have to kind of decide what you're willing to deal with, but especially during this heat time of year, anytime the lawn is stressed, going into dormancy, and then there's also dogs going out on it, that's gonna pretty easily cause some dog spots. Now, if you'd like to know how to fix those spots or a couple options for it, I have a video from earlier this spring on fixing some of those spots in your yard, what the possibilities are, so go check that out if you'd like to learn that part. Now, the other thing about dormancy or heat stress is try to keep minimal traffic on the yard if possible during this time. So if your yard is really brown and really stressed out, then try to keep people off of it playing as much as possible. If that can't really happen, then you just have to know that there may be some more damage that happens. The plant is already in a really stressful time, and a bunch of traffic trampling on it can do some damage to it too. Everything's fixable, everything can come back when ideal temperatures come. And in the fall time here, you'll wanna stay tuned because I'll be talking about how you can really get your yard ready in the fall as a best time for cool season yards. And I'll show you some of what I do here to make sure that I have it ready for the next year and minimal stress will happen. If you happen to be getting actually too much rain and you're experiencing a lot of heat and humidity, the other cause for possible brown spots could be fungus. Now, there's an absolute multitude of different kinds of fungus, so I can't go into absolutely everything that could be happening. There's just too much to cover in that, and it's very hard to identify every single type as well because there's so many of them. But they do make a couple of homeowner products that I have used before. This product here called Disease X is one of them. Covers a lot of broad things as far as fungus goes. Then there's also this other one here that I have used as well. So if you are seeing some brown areas and some spots maybe on the leaves of the grass, you've been experiencing a lot of wet, humid weather, then I would definitely do a little more research and look into fungus and what might be going on there. Maybe if some of these products would help out with that. You just have to do your best on getting through the summer heat. I hope I gave you some good information today on what might be going on in your yard. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next time.